check us out on Patreon, guys, where we're giving you the entire year now for $10.08. Over 100 videos worth of content for $10.08.
8 cents is just such a slap in the face.
Like 84 cents a month, I think is what it comes out to.
I haven't seen 84 cents in 15 years. I'm telling you. Ever since Penny Candy.
So check us out on Patreon, guys. Hope to see you there.
The entire year.
AC motherfucking DC, y'all. Y'all know what time it is. I'm Ryan George, Las Vegas. Get the formalities out the way. AC motherfucking DC. That's my shit, damn
man. Shout out to the Free Thinkers, man. We'll throw that out there, man. You know what I'm saying?
Dude,
we're gonna abandon the intro for these guys.
I'm excited, man, because the last video we did a couple years ago was Hell's Bells.
Yes.
Right? And then
big video for us too.
It was. And I enjoyed the hell out of that song. And we did a piece of what's the song?
We did Dirty Deeds Done Cheap and all that. We did that on Patreon.
On Patreon, but we did Thunderstruck.
A snippet of it. Yep.
A little piece of that. And I was like, man, this group, I just love their energy and I love their sound. I just love everything about them, man.
I was going to ask you, man, because we may need to do a video on our favorite bands since we started this journey in metal and rock. And I was going to ask you, because I get the feeling that AC/DC might be one of your favorite bands.
Not at all, man. Why would you say that? No, I love them, man. You're right, though, man.
And I love AC/DC as well. I think they're great. And the funny thing about AC/DC, before we get into talking about the new album, apparently, that they have, we get so many people. It's almost like this sort of eye roll is what I feel like when I see the tone in the text, like, oh, okay, yeah, AC/DC, because you guys have heard AC/DC being blasted on the radio
for so long,
because they're one of the most played bands, from what I remember hearing someone say or reading somewhere. So for you guys, this is just like, oh, AC/DC,
another AC/DC song.
We're not from that world, man. Mm-hmm. AC/DC is fire.
I'm sure people felt that way about Jordan when he was winning all them championships.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, Bulls are in the championship. Yeah, they're gonna win again, but it was still fire to me.
It's still fire. But you know, so that's the thing that I realized, man, about AC/DC is that when we do these videos, I mean, we do pretty good views on AC/DC, but when we do these videos, there's a lot of people in the comments like, okay, can you do this band? Mm-hmm. Can you do somebody else? Because you're used to hearing AC/DC all day, every day, because you listen to rock radio, or that's just part of your life. But no, man, let us take that journey, man.
Let us enjoy it.
They're legends, clearly. Anyways, they got a new album out, right?
Yes, new album, Power Up, Shot in the Dark is the name of the song we're going to do today. And they've got 12 tracks on there, man. Money Shot, that's funny.
Money Shot is hilarious.
So I'm hoping, man, because I like AC/DC, man. So I'm hoping I'm going to like this song. Don't let me down, AC/DC. You know what I'm saying? I'm going hard for y'all right now. So I'm hoping that I can rock out to this, man.
Yeah, and the funny thing is I was about to say, Ryan, I was going to say, why haven't people been requesting this? But I'm keeping it real, man. I haven't been really in the comments as much.
Neither one of us.
These days. So maybe there are a lot of people that are saying, hey, get that new AC/DC done. Shout out to everyone that's requested for us to do this. We just happened to be on YouTube and saw AC/DC. And we were like, wait a minute, is that new? Without further ado, we're going to do Shot in the Dark by the great AC/DC, man. Album's called Power Up, huh?
Oh, yeah. Man. Yep.
Now it's AC/DC.
Sounds exactly like I thought it was going to sound. Playlist for me. I don't know if you heard that, but playlist for me.
How old are the members of AC/DC?
Man? I don't know.
They're like
fine wine.
No, they're like the old dudes at the YMCA that are still bust your ass, though. You know what I'm saying?
With the basketball.
You know, they got the goggles on and all. You may clown the knee pads and all that, but they still got the jump shot, man. They still bust your ass.
Calling plays and certain. Like
blue. Yeah.
And Brian Johnson sounds exactly the same. It doesn't sound like he aged a minute. To your point, right? To your point of how old
I don't know what, if there's studio magic involved or if that's how he sounds live, but he sounds pretty similar.
Yeah,
you know
what
I mean? He sounds like, okay, I can still get in the gym.
I can still do this.
I can still, you know, shoot up a couple jump shots on you youngsters, man. I really want to know how old they are, because I'm guessing maybe 60s. You know, give us some feedback on the ages of them in the comments, man. Maybe 70s, to be honest with you. Had to cut real quick, man. Phil Rudd is 66 years old. Shout out to Mr. Phil Rudd. Brian Johnson, 73, I believe.
Yeah.
Cliff Williams is 70.
70, yeah.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah, dude.
You know what I'm saying? So I do want to see them live, though. I want to, because remember when Michael Jackson said the BMAs need to
the spin, and it was super
rest
slow.
Rest in peace to the great Michael Jackson. Yeah. When he did the spin, I was like, okay, he still might, but that spin was a little slow.
It was like, so, it was like in slow motion.
So he is human. He does age. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, but my point in saying all that, guys, is that, man, they sound great. You know what I mean? They sound great. It sounds very AC/DC-ish. They kept. They
preserved that sound.
They're giving you exactly what you would expect for them to give you.
And I'm okay with that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Because I know sometimes we get into, oh man, we want it to sound like this and be innovative and stuff like that. But man, if what is being repeated, that's your phrase. If what is being repeated is fire to me, hey, keep that mug going. Yep. Keep it going.
With that being said, let's get back to it. Let's just start it back up. Fuck it.
I ain't mad at you. Let's turn it up. It's already loud as hell, but. Hey! One more time. We'll bring that back, man. We'll bring that back. I know you want to get to the lyrics because that is ridiculously funny. But I will say, man, when you're listening to this, man, and I want to. This is a question for our subs, pretty much more than you, George. I know this is not necessarily. Well, I don't know, but I'm assuming that this is not necessarily difficult to play. But I just love the way it sounds, man. And I just think that this is just dope and fly, and it still has a grit to it and a rock sound.
Yeah.
But it may not be that difficult, but do you guys jam out to this? I guess that's the question. Number one, is it difficult? But number two, is it because it's maybe if the answer to that question is not difficult, do you discredit it? Like, oh, well, that's not that difficult to play. So it's just classic AC/DC. So I'm not going to give it credit. Or is it, yeah, it's not that difficult to play, but the shit is still hot. The shit is still fire. It sounds good. Mm-hmm. And I respect it. That's a little, you know, let me know what you guys think.
They're going to get drowned out by the AC/DC fans underneath the video. I don't know if we're going to hear from those people.
Because that shit's fire.
The naysayers. But it sounds good, though.
Yeah,
that's just fire. It just sounds like rock and roll. Like, AC/DC just has such a pure rock and roll song. And you had mentioned just how the riffs sound. The riffs capture a grittiness, a hardness, but make it feel like a party. And sometimes it just sounds like you're just making a corny party song.
Yeah.
But they're able to just how they tone their instruments, and with Brian's voice, the grittiness in his voice, it sounds like a hard, rocked out good time, man. Mm-hmm. That's just what it is with AC/DC. Now on to the lyrics. I don't want to make this sexual because you know they're in their 70s, but then again, Viagra. Never mind.
Dude. Yeah, you're still bugging. You're still bugging.
And I hope. Yeah. I can only hope. Then I'm still. Never mind. Are the lyrics sexual or not? I don't know.
I'd rather go blind and keep my dick in than to stop having sex and be able to see fine.
I don't even need to be able to walk. I can just, as long as that works, I can just wheel my ass on over to. I'm sorry.
AC/DC to me just brings it, exactly what their name suggests, right? AC/DC, AC is, I think, alternating current, and DC is direct current, electricity, right?
Yep.
That's exactly what their music sounds like. It's electric. That's exactly what it sounds like. It gives me a shot of energy. A shot of energy. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It just sounds that way to me.
The album's called Power Up. You know what I'm saying? So that album is just like, we're going to give you exactly what we've always given you. That's what we're going to do. So shout out to them, man. You know, we're enjoying this, man. Let's get back to it. Guys are, man. Come on.
Dude, you know what, man? George.
Come on, man.
That was right on time for me.
I was AC/DC like a motherfucker right there. Even had that much experience, all right, Ryan?
Yeah. No. You're good, man. This was exactly what I needed, man. After Eddie Van Halen passing away, man, I needed something to kind of like give me a shot in the arm. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And that's what this does to me. Now, if I'm being 100% honest, guys, I'm not in love with the chorus. I think it's kind of bland, but they still pull it off. It's just, I don't care what they perform. I shouldn't say that because maybe I need to do more of a deep dive into their discography. But from what I've heard, man, to me, I don't give a fuck what they're playing. I'm banging it. Even if it's kind of like mediocre, I'm still like, dude, the shit still sounds good to me. It just I just like the shit. Yeah. It's just hot to me.
And a lot of you guys said that they stopped touring when we were, because we asked on one of the videos. I don't know if we released that to YouTube, but we were like, hey, man, can we see AC/DC? And then a lot of you guys said that they had retired, I believe. Mm-hmm. And clearly they have a new album out. So it looks like they're going to be on tour, I would imagine.
I hope so.
After this whole COVID thing dies down. So
I hope so, because I would really like to see them, man.
I would love to see them.
Because you know that's going to be a party.
Yep.
That's going to be a fun-ass time.
Yep.
So.
Anything that they put out at this point, to me, is just bonus shit. It's just a bonus. If it's halfway decent, it's just bonus, man. Yep. They're solidified legends. We really just happen to... And guys, we've been critical of legends.
Yes, we have.
In the rock and metal world, man, and pretty much everywhere, in every capacity, every genre. But as it relates to rock and metal, we've been very critical and have not liked rock and metal legends.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Quite a bit. So
if you want to know one in particular, check us out on Patreon. And you'll know about a shitstorm that I received in the comments. But.
Yeah. We did. And I wasn't even that hard on the band. You know what I'm saying? I kind of rocked with some of the songs, but I got the collateral damage and shit. Yeah. There's a big band in particular that we weren't like blown away by, a rock royalty band. That, we got the raft of our patrons on not liking some of those songs. But AC/DC is a band that we genuinely, we just like. We like their sound. So, and they stay true to it. The lyrics, whatever. I think the lyrics are supposed to be sort of comedic in some sense. And they, you know, kind of dialed in to a degree. But they kept their essence in this, in my opinion.
Yeah, so, man.
Salute to these guys. Still doing it. 60, 70 years old.
Dude, and, that's impressive, dude.
Dude, that's incredible. And that's more so what I was focused on, is just appreciating
these
guys.
When's the last time you seen a 70-year-old just outside doing shit? I don't see that.
Outside?
Yeah.
You know, just outside.
Man, yes. My grandmother born when the street lights is on, before the street lights, she is in the house. Like, I know I got to get home. I can't be out when it's dark. And, oh, it's windy today. I can't even be outside. It's windy today. Yeah, like, what? It's wind? Grandma, it's wind. Like, no. I can't be out.
Bro. No. Anyways, man, shout out to everybody that requested that. We didn't see it, but we appreciate the effort. You know what I mean? We'll be looking in the comments more and more as time progresses. But that's it. That's the end of the video, guys. If you enjoyed that, please hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And also, guys, check out our Patreon channel if you're interested. It will allow you to get exclusive access to our content. The link for that will be in the description. I'm George. That's Ryan, Las Vegas.
We out.